This is a common emitter amplifier, and today we will perform a small signal or AC model analysis and will determine the circuit input, output resistance, and also will calculate the amplifier voltage gain VO to VS. As you can see from this AC model, when we perform a small signal analysis, we assume all the DC supply sources are grounded and all the capacitors are shorted. Therefore, resistors RC and R1 along RL are placed between output terminal and the ground, so all of them become in parallel. Likewise, the resistor R2 is placed between the base and the ground. The collector current is modeled with a controlled source linked to the input current by beta. Also looking into the base of the transistor, the base emitter resistance equal to the beta plus 1 multiplied by the emitter's dynamic resistance, lowercase re. Please note that here the biasing resistor re at the emitter is not bypassed to the ground by a capacitor, so it will appear between emitter and ground in the AC model. To begin, let's calculate the transistor emitter current because we will need this value to determine the emitter's dynamic resistance. For this circuit, the collector DC voltage is given, which is 5 volt. So we simply can determine the current flowing through the resistor RC by the Ohm law. Therefore, we can write and this current includes base and the collector current. Which this is the same as the emitter current. Now we can calculate the emitter dynamic resistance by dividing the base emitter junction terminal voltage VT by the emitter current. So we can write where VT is 26 millivolt at the room temperature. To determine the amplifier input resistance, we will be looking into the base of the transistor as shown here in this AC equivalent circuit. What we will see as the input resistance is R2 in parallel with beta plus 1 by dynamic resistance plus RE. So we can write so the theoretical value of the input resistance is 4.3 kilo ohm. By the way, if you like what you are watching, please hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. This will really help the channel to grow and encourage me to continue creating more and better content. Now back to the video, and we will determine the output resistance by looking from the load resistor RL terminal. In this case, we can see that the resistor RC and R1 are in parallel. So we can write the output resistance is about 6 kilo ohm. Please note this value can be slightly less in practice because we didn't consider the collector emitter dynamic resistance. Now we look into determining the voltage gain from the load terminal to the source terminal. Here we have to be a bit mindful because of the source resistance RS. As we can see, the RS is in series with the VS and the amplifier input resistance RI. The resistor RS will attenuate the input signal, so it will reduce the circuit overall gain VO to VS. For simplicity, we split the overall circuit gain as follows. Where VI is located at the amplifier input terminal. To determine VO to VI, which is the common emitter amplifier gain, we can write this expression means all the resistance is being seen from the collector terminal divided by all resistance seen from the emitter terminal. And the minus is representing the 180 degree phase shift between output and input. Please note, when we look from the emitter terminal, we see the emitter dynamic resistance and RE in series. So let's calculate VO to VI. Therefore, the common emitter amplifier gain is about 30. Now we are going to find VI to VS gain, which is considered a simple voltage divider. So the RS will reduce the signal gain by 0.81. Therefore, we can find the circuit overall gain as follows. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I will be making more videos reviewing BJT amplifier circuits. So please subscribe and push the notification bell if you would like to get notified when I publish new videos.